mau bawa ke, semuanya aku bawa kayak diret lagi nih ya nanti ya. Oh iya, Pak, kangen banget sama teman-teman acara di sana. Oh, dengan thank you yang organize ya, dan thank you semangat teman-teman semua. Ya, aku merasa honor ya pada datang ke sini karena pengen ketemu aku kan?
Iya.
Oke, mudah-mudahan sukses ya.
Terima kasih kedatangannya. Terima kasih sudah memberikan support kepada kegiatan kemarin ini.
Siswa-siswi kami dan yang berkepentingan langsung atau tidak langsung terhadap pendidikan khususnya di daerah Jawa Barat ini. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, Engkau Maha mengetahui terhadap kelemahan-kelemahan kami, terhadap kekurangan-kekurangan kami. Maka dari itu, kepada-Mulah kami menyembah orang beriman sebelum kami. Rabbana atina dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adzabannar. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wassalamu alal mursalin, alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Amin ya rabbal alamin. Terima kasih. Berikutnya kita masuk ke laporan
pendidikan dan tenaga pendidikan Dinas Pendidikan Provinsi Jawa Barat, Bapak Abdul Mustikawanto. Yang kami hormati Mr. Dosen, Bapak Yesa, para tamu undangan yang kami banggakan dan para segenap panitia yang kita bina. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Segala puji dan senang yang dari Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, Tuhan Yang Maha Esa, yang telah memberikan kesempatan kepada kita semua untuk hadir dalam kegiatan seminar kali ini. Rasa syukur itulah menggagas seminar internasional ini, sekaligus juga sebagai ajang reuni dan silaturahmi para alumni. Rasa terima kasih kami kepada pemerintah daerah Provinsi Jawa Barat melalui Dinas Pendidikan yang telah memberangkatkan lebih dari 700 guru dari tingkat SD, SMP, dan SMK dan SMK serta kepala sekolah.
Kita lebih banyak bermain game, lebih akrab dengan gadget yang tidak untuk membaca, tapi lebih untuk menonton, lebih untuk membuli, bullying di antara kawan-kawannya, mungkin hal-hal yang iseng yang lain. Maka bagaimana tugas kita semua membudayakan, membiasakan sehingga literasi menjadi kultur, termasuk verbal tidak ada kekerasan, fisik tidak ada kekerasan seksual. Sekarang ini muncul berbagai fenomena. Nah, untuk lain kali ada guru yang mencabuli murid. Betul enggak? Dengan ucapan basmalah, bismillahirrahmanirrahim, International Seminar Tikyun apa? TFEL to the next level conducting classroom action research based on TFEL framework, saya nyatakan dibuka. Semoga Allah SWT senantiasa memberkati kita. Bila itu aku berhidayah, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Teacher, the champion teacher of West Java. Kalau saya kata, saya tanya, how are you today?
Dijen prinsipal.
Oh, teacher, yes.
Dan pengawas.
Yes. Now let's say like this, then. The champion educator from West Java. Kami yang di depan, you are great. Dua kali, yes. Dan semuanya,
we are great.
Tiga kali,
yes.
Secara berurutan dengan cepat, dengan energi yang paling kuat, karena ruangan ini sudah dibayar untuk ribut, ya kan? Alright, now as a champion, okay? Now. The champion educator from West Java. How are you today?
I'm great. Yes, you are great. Yes, we are great. Yes.
Saya tidak dengar sentakan kakinya mana. The champion.
Yes, we are great. Yes.
Okay, itu baru standar ya, jadi okay, sit down.
Suaranya nggak begitu bagus ya. Yang jelas ini udah riset dari seluruh dunia ya, bagaimana kita harus menekankan kepada kita sendiri dan anak-anak kita yang dia bilang tadi the power of yet. Maksudnya the power of yet itu kita kalau di Indonesia kayaknya udah pada ahli kayak gitu semuanya belum. Kalau ditanya udah nikah belum, pasti kita bilangnya belum kan. Kalau di sana are you married, pasti bilangnya no. Kalau di Asia. Kalau di luar nggak cuma Australia, tapi makanya no. Kalau kita pasti not yet, ya. Sebenarnya sudah bagus sekali kita power of yet-nya. Jadi itu yang kita tekankan ke anak-anak bahwa sesuatu itu kalau misalnya susah atau apa, jangan bilang tidak bisa, jangan bilang no, tapi not yet, ya. Something yang not yet yang kita akan capai nantinya, oke? Tekankan kita sendiri dan semuanya power of yet remember that one. Kalau di sekolah nanti ke student kita tekankan juga itu power of yet. Kemudian fixed mindset, ada fixed mindset dan growth mindset, pasti ada yang ingat apa?
From here they say apa katanya internasional, ya kan, ngomong-ngomong Sunda wae. Alright, so let me to And I believe that your English is good.
Yeah.
All right. So the growth mindset is the foundation for everyone to grow, of course, as it is said by the title. But for many people, this sounds very simple, but this is actually very important. Why? For example, we always deal with people who has the fixed mindset that level themselves that they cannot do something specific. For example, let's play soccer. No, I'm not born as a soccer player. All right? I'm a dancer. Yes, maybe that's the dominant skill that you train over time. But don't level yourself that you cannot do that. All right? This becomes important when we bring this understanding into the school. Okay? We as a teachers sometimes very easily to label the students. He's not good. What's that? Ahmad. No wonder. He's not good at math. Okay? No matter how hard the math teacher try, he's not gonna do it. Okay? So having fixed mindset is actually dangerous. Dangerous for the students, sorry. And then just for us. Because then we are very easily to label people. Okay? Having growth mindset. For example, when you face the challenge, people who tended to have fixed mindset, they try to avoid challenge. Okay? They try to avoid. For the people who have growth mindset, they will say, whenever they face challenge, they will say, Alhamdulillah, I have the opportunity to prove myself that I can do it. Yeah? So this is sounds very simple, but again, this is very important. And in many times, we are trapped to this simple thing, as if it's like, well, I cannot do that. Okay? In the school, this becomes very fundamental mindset for you to have. For you to have. Okay? Do not label the students very easily with what you see. Yeah? The students are doing every day. There's always potential for everyone to grow in anything. The task for the teacher is to give the positive energy. Okay? That is why when you told me the story that you give always the time for the students to give the positive energy, even with a small thing, how are you to do? I'm great! Alright? That's give the positive energy to grow toward the fixed, the growth mindset, growing the positivity in everyday life. Okay? Teaching math, teaching English, or you name it, it's easy when you have the right foundation. And that foundation is the growing mindset. Okay? So try to avoid to say, I cannot be doing that. So the power of not yet is not identical to the with the power of cannot. Yeah? Jadi selalu gunakan. It sounds simple, but this is the foundation of growing mindset. Yeah? So for the obstacle, the children who are trained with the growing mindset, even the adult with the growing mindset, whenever you face obstacle, mindset. But the growing mindset, again, they will say, this is the opportunity for me. Yeah? This is the opportunity for me. Sometimes in many simple things, in life we face, okay? And you have been in Adelaide, I challenge you not eating rice if you don't have any. Yeah, kan? Masih ingat kan? That's part of the thing that you exercise yourself into the growing mindset area, okay? Always challenge yourself.
Kan nanti akan kalau ada berubah kita makin suffer atau ada pain kita akan apa menikmatinya kalau dengan perubahan. Saya akan percepat aja dengan waktunya ya. Bagaimana kita menilai bahwa dari pain itu dari ke suffer itu kita akan mendapat value yang akan lebih ya. Kalau kita merasa yang stres ini sebenarnya semua juga tahu aku lagi stres. Stres itu sebetulnya gimana kita memandangnya, gimana kita melihat sesuatu itu kita reframe meaningnya atau artinya, bagaimana kita mengubah pemikirannya juga, dan bagaimana kita selalu membatasi diri kita. Saya cuma mampunya segitu yang tadi itu yang fixed mind itu ya. Saya cuma mampunya segitu. Nah, kebiasaan kepercayaan-percayaan kayak gitu yang kita harus ubah ya. Berikutnya mungkin saya sebentar lagi aja sedikit lagi prinsipnya ya. Prinsipnya sesuatu kemudian kita percaya dengan asumsi, percaya dengan apa yang sudah dinormalkan oleh sekitar kita. Sesuatu sebetulnya nggak benar tapi dinormalkan, jadi kelihatannya normal ya. Kemudian bagaimana kita mengambil dari yang setiap dari sesuatu yang negatif, bagaimana kita mengambil yang positifnya. Mungkin ada teknik berikutnya yang Tommy yang bisa mereka berikutnya coba next slide please. Ya, kalau kita ada pasti kok dalam pikiran kita pasti selalu ada ya negatif. Pemikiran negatif itu pasti selalu ada ya. Nah, itu yang kita kita coba ini yang
dan informasi saya sebelum saya kembalikan bahwa sebenarnya materi ini adalah materi program leadership selama 2 hari non-stop yang dibawakan ke Bu Rini dalam waktu 20 menit. Dan kalau ada teman-teman yang masih pengen, sebenarnya materinya sangat-sangat komplit. Daripada kita menjadi begini, tapi kita akan sharing ke panitia untuk dikopikan ke semuanya. Ya, oke. Okay. Kembalikan ke Bu Rini, tolong dulu.
Okay.
Jadi ini landasannya kita beri aplaus yang meriah untuk Ibu.
Ya, tanpa harus disimpulkan ya. Yang jelas kalau fixed mindset pasti kalau melihat suasana seminar teh ada moderator di sana ngecetul gitu ya. Pembicaranya kan sekarang saya rubah jadi fixed mindset moderator duduk di belakang. Karena berarti sama ingin punya itu. Kalau yang tercara kan punya minggir kan. Mr. Tommy, are you okay? Okay. Thank you.
Dan saya berkulu di Australia. Ya. Tapi meskipun, even though it is created and developed in Australia, there are some universal principles. Because teaching, wherever you go, still the same. It's teaching. Okay? The only thing different is the way you do it. Okay, so TEFL, Teaching for Effective Learning, is like an internal compass where show you the direction where to go. All right, and in your seminar kit, probably you would have this, and I believe that yang di belakang pasti gak bisa lihat ini, ya. Yang di depan aja untung-untungan bisa lihat, gitu. So, ada di seminar kit di situ. Saya jelaskan sejak singkat bahwa TEFL memiliki 4 domain. Domain yang pertama itu learning for effective teaching. Termasuk di dalamnya adalah professional development and it's universal. Okay? So this is the reason it's only formal umbrella. But the best practices are universal. You can just fit into the system, okay? For example, teaching the students to be disciplined. You don't need to talk about the system. Everywhere is the same, okay? For example, teaching the students how to get their things done. Homework, motivation, you don't need to talk about the system. The best practices are universal. The values in the best practices are universal. You can implement them everywhere. Okay? That is why I encourage you to be the model for this. Okay? And all out Indonesia, throughout the country, again, I'm telling you the truth, throughout the very inspiring, but I'm suggesting you, now that you have that leverage, okay, sudah ada nama gue penulis, itu penting. Sudah ada nama gitu, now start adding the content of effective learning. Not simply sweet memory somewhere sitting down under the trees, listening to this, looking for the kangaroos, okay? People going there, I'm catching up the bus, I took the wrong bus, and not only that's a good memory to keep you motivated, but then with teaching for effective learning framework, start putting in the context. Okay? That's what will make you a true champion. Okay? Again, millions of teachers in Indonesia need you. Yeah? I'm telling you this. Millions of teachers in Indonesia need people like you to share your knowledge. Okay? You have the privilege to upgrade your skill, your knowledge, go visiting abroad, and let not just the story you bring back, but also the content knowledge. And to do that,
you need to go back to understand the framework of teaching for effective learning. Because not everyone, if I ask, okay, the question, what do you mean by effective learning? Not everyone can answer that. What do you mean by effective teaching? Not everyone can answer that. Even worse, when I ask the question, do you think your teaching is effective? Not everyone answer that correctly. Because the most common answer is, I don't know, I'm not sure. Okay? Now that you have the resources, you have the guideline, you have the standard for you to evaluate and assess your best practices. And my alarm clock is ready. Means my time is finished, but don't worry, all the materials, 92 slides here are complete, and the soft copy of the teaching for effective learning will be given to you after this session. And for those who just know me, who just met today, and you need more discussion about teaching for effective learning, just write down my name, Tommy at knowledgeexchange.net.au, and we can discuss through email, or for those who haven't connected with me through social media, yeah, I'm available on social media, on Facebook, on Twitter, on LinkedIn, you name it, I got it. Okay, and again, thank you for your spirit, and thank you for having us today. I hope that this is not the only time that we meet. I hope that there are more meetings to motivate and learning together like this. And at the end of my presentation, allow me to say appreciation for the committee. Panitia sudah bekerja luar biasa, ya. Kalau saya bisa mengusulkan, sebenarnya bisa masuk Guinness Book karena kecepatan apa namanya, setidaknya rekor muri karena bekerja dalam waktu yang sangat singkat, ya, only 2 weeks, dan mulai dari dana yang tidak ada. Ini luar biasa, dan saya pikir semuanya harus berpengaruh untuk kerja keras panitia dan alumni boleh pertahankan kerja keras ini, karena sekali lagi, kalau bukan kita yang berubah pendidikan di Indonesia, di Jawa Barat, siapa lagi? And you are the champion teacher. Now, champion educator from West Java, how are you today?
Flexibility to accommodate all three sectors of education, the schools, vocational sector, and the higher education. They are all interlinked to each other. Unlike many countries in Asia, the vocational sector is not embedded into higher education, which creates a lot of problem for students to move on to the bachelor's degree or master's degree. The beauty of Australian qualification framework is you can start with the vocational programs and you can still end up completing your bachelor's or master's degree. They have consulted all the stakeholders involved in the process. So that's why it is very comprehensive and address the needs of all sectors. So therefore, the students, the graduates, and employers, the purpose of education, what is the purpose of education? Employability. So we need to really take employers into account. So
yes. Yeah, I'm from high school to Majalengka, somewhere in the east of West Java. Okay, I couldn't catch all your explanation, so I have three questions for you. Number one, AQF offers certificate from level 1 until level 10. Okay, how to get the certificate? The first question. Number two.
Can I answer one at a time? I answer your first question, then you ask second question.
Okay.
Now, that slide is gone. As I mentioned, the certificate.
So what is the championship in there? Yeah? They can solve their problem. So this is interesting. Why? Because everyone, every single teacher has their own definition. But for me, you don't have to memorize all the grammars if I'm teaching English. Okay? The champion students for me is if you can make yourself be at school on time. To me, that simple thing, you are a champion. Because there's thousands of people cannot even make themselves on time. Millions of people even it's hard for them to be on time. So if one people can make it on time, that's a champion. So it's again back to the root of life. What is the purpose of life and what is success? Okay? If you can fulfill that, that's the champion. For me, what is the criteria of champion students? Well, my champion students, and this is what I'm teaching to my kids as well, you don't need to have high degree, formal high degree. You just need to be a sensible man, to live. Live peacefully with your neighbor, okay? Live peacefully with the nature, and you are the champion of life. So, our task, for me, my task as a teacher to prepare this student to be champion is actually to be champion in life. What they need to be champion in life? Well, everyone has different needs. And the task of the teacher is to facilitate, to unleash their truly potential to reach their lead, to reach their goal in life. That's the champion teacher. So again, when this is asked, so what is the champion teacher then? The champion teachers are those who can help the students to be the champion students, to achieve their goals. I think that's a bit philosophical, a bit very wide, but that's really the key, the bottom line of what does it mean to be champion. Okay, champion in life, in everything, even in a very simple thing. Thank you.
I think this was the normal is the high school is registered by the Act of Parliament, so it's by the law. So South Australia school system, we have 13 years of schooling system in South Australia. 8 years primary, why 8 years? Probably some of you will ask, how 8 years come 8 years? So my children, he's 5 years old now. He went to primary school at 5 years old and going to reception, or we call it preschool. So the primary school is start from the reception of preschool. So 1 year preschool, and year one, year two, year three, year four, year five, year six, year seven. So all end up become 8 years primary school schooling. And junior secondary, here we call SMP, right? Okay, so 3 years SMP, then in South Software, we also has 3 years. So year 8, year 9, and year 10. So 8 years primary, 3 years junior secondary, and last 6, South Australia Certificate of Education is a 2 years program. So that's what I'm going to talk about today. It's a 2 year qualification, taught in English. Students can select subjects from a wide range. So they can select from, for example, vocational education system like IMWOD or AIDT, or they can select from other normal academic program. So the SAIS, if you would like to attend the SAIS certificates, you need to complete 200 credits. Normally, a compulsory subject has 110 credits. So, including like personal learning plan, English literature.
Saya tinggal di Kalijati, di Subang. Ada yang di Subang, di Majalengka, di mana aja di sejauh mana ada banyak. Tapi tidak ada di kota Bandung, hanya di kabupaten.
So cute.
Bapak dan Ibu, beliau saya hadirkan ke sini untuk sampel. Kebetulan dia sudah dan ingin akan ke Adelaide barangkali. Ya, nanti setelah dari sini selesai, Peace Corps selesai, kemungkinan besar kalau dia jadi dengan Bu Rini dan teman-teman yang lain, barangkali ya, dia akan kerja di Adelaide, bisa membantu teman-teman yang ada di sini. Karena beliau sudah tahu betul di Jawa Barat. Baik, terima kasih, Emma. Atur nuhun ya. Oke, bisa dan mungkin. So, Bapak dan Ibu kurang lebih ringkasan seperti itu. Nah, sekarang Pak Agus ada sedikit kiat-kiat memberikan kepada Bapak, diberikan kepada Bapak dan Ibu supaya nanti yang akhir kedepannya bahwa Dinas Pendidikan Provinsi Jawa Barat menjadi provinsi yang termaju di Indonesia, dan kitalah teman-teman yang ada di sini menjadi perintis untuk mendukung hal itu ya, obsesi itu. Pak Agus, cepat ya, silakan.
Thank you very much, Pak Gordon. I really appreciate the chance to be here today. Siapa di antara bapak-bapak dan ibu-ibu yang pernah melihat muka saya? Ada yang tinggal di Sarojadi? Ya ada? Oh enggak ya, Sarojadi Bandung ya. Itu kampung halaman saya ya. Ya, anak saya dibesarkan di Sarojadi. Jadi kalau nanti mereka jadi calon presiden, ya mereka ditanya dari mana, ya akan dijawab Sarojadi. Jadi begitu, yes. I'm so happy to be here. Saya senang sekali bisa bertemu dengan bapak-bapak dan ibu-ibu ya. Saya seperti yang diceritakan Mbak Bur tadi ya, keliling Jawa Barat, ternyata saya jatuh cinta sama Jawa Barat. Jadi kira akan ya tinggal di sini mungkin selama 3 tahun, 5 tahun. Sudah 15 tahun lewat ya. Anak saya sudah besar. Begitu. Mereka ya bisa berbahasa Indonesia, tapi kadang-kadang susah mencari teman di Amerika. Mereka ada dua anak saya sudah kuliah di sana, tapi ada juga mahasiswa yang dari Indonesia. Jadi kadang-kadang mereka bertemu dengan pakai bahasa Indonesia, buat kaget. dari mana tahu bahasa Indonesia ya? Karena kalau tinggal di Australia atau di Amerika, jarang sekali ada yang mau memakai bahasa Indonesia kalau bule. Tapi harusnya bule gila ya, yang bugil ya. Seperti saya ya. Begitu ya. Saya hanya mau membahas secara singkatnya. Kita perlu membantu. Kemudian kalau sudah ada fondasinya, ada dindingnya, yang dibangun ya itu dengan ucapan, dengan membaca, dengan tulis, keterampilan yang ditambah. Kemudian tata bahasa seperti atap rumah. Itu kenapa saya buat gambar rumah saya muncul begitu. Tapi itu seperti atap rumah. Jadi bukan fondasi. Jadi kita belajar bertingkat. Kemudian kalau sudah dewasa, kita nggak mau belajar berbicara dulu. Kita pengen guru bahasa mengajar tata bahasa. Jadi buat rumah ini balik. Dari keterampilan yang terakhir dikuasai adalah berbicara. Ya, ini ada pointer enggak? Itu bagus. Oke ya. Jadi ada yang merah ya. Jadi kita kalau buat fondasi tata bahasa, kita takut salah. Jadi pusing. Saya pernah bertanya kepada guru bahasa Inggris di mana saya lupa di Bogor ya. I said, "What's your name?" And dia, bukan karena saya bintang filmnya, tapi dia hanya pusing dengan tata bahasa, betul? Jadi kalau kita dilatih sama teori terus, itu membuat dan menyebabkan kita takut salah, malu berbicara, betul nggak, bapak-bapak? Udah pernah dirasakan ya? Nggak, jadi kalau ada bule dan tanya, what's your name, where did you go, where are you, like, all of these questions, kemudian pusing-pusing ditambah ya, karena sedang berpikir tentang struktur. Tapi kalau itu latihan, kita bisa membuat. Jadi ini rumah saya dibalikan ya, mau tinggal di situ? Nggak mau ya, tapi nggak mau tinggal di rumah tanpa ada atap juga ya. Jadi tidak seperti membuang tata bahasa, hanya ada waktunya kalau sudah percaya diri. Jadi ya, kita mengembangkan masalah takut salah, maaf ya, dan pusing karena 16 tenses, kemudian malu ya. Ya, guru bahasa Inggris cukup ya waktu ditanya begitu ya. Kemudian kurang latihan, kurang percaya diri. Jadi kita kalau belajar bulu tangkis pasti dilatih di lapangan ya. Tidak hanya belajar teori saja ya. Tidak hanya dilatih dengan peraturan, dihafal, bisa diulang lagi. Kalau ada ujian, saya dapat skornya tinggi dengan teori, tapi tidak pernah main bulu tangkis. Untuk apa itu? Untuk apa itu, bapak-bapak? Kita nggak membantu kalau nggak ada latihan yang nyata. Yang nyata berarti kita memaksa siswa kita untuk ngomong. Jadi kalau mau belajar bulu tangkis tanpa turun ke lapangan, tidak akan menguasai ya keterampilan atau tidak akan bisa main bulu tangkis ya. Jadi kita belajar teori ya, tidak membuang teori, tapi belajar pada waktunya. Kalau sudah mulai ngomong, sudah mulai bisa membaca begitu, tapi belajar bersama-sama, tidak hanya sendiri begitu. Jadi Pak Abur sudah bercerita tentang ini. Waktu itu Kepala Dinas Pendidikan Pak Wahyudi Jarakasih, dia bertanya, Pak Abur, mana Pak Bruce yang lain? Boleh ditambah? Saya akan dibelah ya. Itu kemudian dibuat dua ya. Tapi nggak perlu dibelah karena ada Emma dan ada relawan Peace Corps yang datang ke Jawa Barat. Sekarang 45 orang. Jadi itu jawaban. Saya hanya memberitahu kepada Pak Wahyudi, doa saja, mudah-mudahan ada yang lain yang datang. Kemudian doa dikabulkan dengan kedatangan Peace Corps. Ada di antara bapak-bapak dan ibu-ibu yang menerima relawan Peace Corps? Ada? Ya, banyak ya. Yang lain belum ya? Aduh, minta aja ke Pak Bur, dia jadi agen ya. Minta aja ya, berani. Begitu aja ya. Tapi di luar, ya, jadi kami membuat program latihan, ada sertifikat, ya, bagus juga ini lewat, karena hanya ada 10 menit, biar waktunya habis, ya. Oke. seharusnya ada tulisan dari Pak Sharma. Mana Pak Sharma? Dia yang harus ada ya. Nah begitu ya. Oke. Kemudian ya, ini kan flashnya pertama waktu ada keberangkatan ke Australia. Jadi kami memakai ujian supaya tahu siapa yang sudah siap untuk pergi ke sana dan tidak akan pusing dengan dipaksa pakai bahasa Inggris. Jadi waktu itu ada wawancara, ada teman saya juga yang membantu begitu.